The X-Zone radio and TV show is largely an opinion talk show. All opinions, comments, or statements of fact expressed by Rob McConnell's guests are strictly their own and are not to be construed as those of the X-Zone radio and TV show or in any manner endorsed by Rob McConnell, rel-mar McConnell Media Company, Talkstar Radio Network, its affiliated stations, or employees.
All Hit Radio.
Welcome to the X Zone, a place where fact is fiction and fiction is reality. Now, here's your host, Rob McConnell.
Welcome back to the X-Zone, everyone. My name is Rob McConnell, coming to you from our studios in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. If you'd like to send us an email, xzone@xzoneradiotv.com. If you'd like to visit our website, www.xzoneradiotv.com. And if you'd like to chat with us online on MSN Messenger, xzoneradiotv@hotmail.com. Graham Hancock is my guest this hour. Graham is the author of Sign and the Seal, Fingerprints of the Gods, Keeper of Genesis, Heaven's Mirror, Supernatural, and other best-selling investigations of historical mysteries. Graham's books have been translated into 27 languages and have sold over 5 million copies worldwide. His public lectures and broadcast, including two major TV series for the Learning Channel, Quest for the Lost Civilizations, and Flooded Kingdoms of the Ice Age, have further established his reputation as an unconventional thinker who raises controversial questions about humanity's past. Written with the same page-turning appeal that has made his nonfiction so popular, the fantasy adventure novel Entangled, published in 2010, is his first work of nonfiction. Joining me now from the United Kingdom is Graham Hancock. And Graham, welcome back to the X-Zone. Great having you with us.
Thank you. It's great to be with you, Rob. I'm looking forward to this discussion.
Graham, you've been researching ancient mysteries for, I believe more than 20 years now. So you should be the man to ask, why does the past really matter?
You know, when I first got into this field with The Sign and the Seal and Fingerprints of the Gods, which was published in 1995, I think I was very naive. I thought that bringing an alternative perspective on the past of humanity would be regarded as helpful and useful. But I discovered that the opposite was true, that there is a very fixed and rigid picture of our past, which is presented to us through the mainstream media and through the education system, and that there's a tremendous reluctance to turn away from this. And what I've realized as time has gone by is that that this is really part of the mind control system in our societies. If you control the past, you also control the present and the future. If you define the past in the way that you want to define it, then you are going to shape how people think in the present and how things go down in the future. So control of the past is power. And I see myself to such an extent as I have a role in this field as a liberating agent, that I am offering alternative points of view and alternative interpretations, sometimes of the same facts that mainstream academia is putting forwards. And in so doing, I hope to shift the balance slightly in the other direction, to liberate the past from the dead hand of academia and political control, and to hand it over to the people who it really belongs to.
Graham, stand by. You and I have got to take a two-minute commercial break. Plenty of food for thought there, Exo Nation. Graham Hancock is our special guest this hour. His website, www.grahamhancock.com. Once again, if you'd like to send us an email, xzone at xzoneradiotv.com, on MSN Messenger, xzoneradiotv at hotmail.com, and our website, www.xzoneradiotv.com. My name is Rob McConnell. Graham Hancock is my guest this hour. We'll both be back on the other side of this two-minute break. Don't go away. With each new extreme weather event or terrorist act, it becomes increasingly obvious that we live in uncertain and challenging times. We all buy car insurance. Why not collapse and catastrophe insurance? Matthew Stein, an MIT-trained engineer and green builder, has written two outstanding books to help people prepare, plan for, and deal with everything from minor situations lasting a few days to full-on collapse. Matt's first book, When Technology Fails, is a manual for self-reliance, sustainable living, and surviving the long emergency. This massive book covers the gamut from first aid and emergency preparedness to alternative healing, renewable energy, primitive living skills, and 18th century technologies that could be critical to your comfort and survival in a long-lasting crisis. Matt's second book, When Disaster Strikes, is a comprehensive emergency preparedness handbook and survival guide. When Disaster Strikes is an essential item for every family's go bag. Both books are available at all usual sources. There's a wealth of totally free information posted at whentechfails.com, and author signed copies may be purchased at mattstein.com. That's www.whentechfails.com and www.mattstein.com. Named one of the world's greatest psychics, Elizabeth Joyce is now giving readings worldwide via Skype. Elizabeth Joyce is recognized for her clairvoyant ability to help find missing persons, her analysis of dreams, past life regression work, mediumship, and her accurate predictions. Elizabeth has been a frequent guest on the X Zone radio show with yours truly, Rob McConnell, now for several years. For an appointment with Elizabeth Joyce, call 201-934-8986 or Skype at elizabeth.joyce. And for more information, you can always visit Elizabeth Joyce online at www.new-visions.com.
Have a disease that you would like to alleviate through a natural means? Have you been contacted by angels, ghosts, or even extraterrestrials and want to validate these experiences? Or would you simply like to speak with someone who can help you find your life's purpose? I'm Dr. Joseph Mara, and I'm offering my services free of charge for first-time clients contacting me during the month of April. These free consultations include angel card readings, guided meditations, life coaching, and energy healing. If you have always wanted to explore these types of experiences but were skeptical or simply could not afford them, then take advantage of this free special offer. Contact me through my website, aguidinglight.com, to schedule your consultation today. Until then, I offer you love, light, and laughter.
Graham Hancock is my guest this hour. Exonation, www.grahamhancock.com. Graham, you talk about a light switch being turned on in the human brain all over the world less than 40,000 years ago. Now, what do you mean by this?
Yeah, this was the mystery that led me to research and write my last nonfiction book, mm-hmm. which is called Supernatural. Meetings with the Ancient Teachers of Mankind. And what really intrigued me, I was looking at the whole subject of human origins, and it's roughly a 6 million year story between the last common ancestor with the chimpanzee and the appearance of anatomically modern humans around about 200,000 years ago. And almost that whole period, our ancestors are just incredibly dull and limited and narrow-minded, with no invention, no creativity, no symbolism, no spirituality, nothing. I call it actually 6 million years of boredom. It even goes on after our ancestors become anatomically modern, this same very narrow, limited, uncreative behavior, and then suddenly, pretty much all over the world and pretty much at once between sort of 40 and 35,000 years ago, it really is as though a light has been switched on in the human brain. And we see this incredible developments taking place, most significantly the beginnings of art and the first evidence of spirituality. We suddenly get incredible paintings on the walls of caves in southern Europe and on rock shelters in Africa and indeed all around the world. And these accompanying exactly the same time that the paintings are created, there's a tremendous leap forward in human behavior and in human abilities. And what the cave paintings document and make clear is that our ancestors have acquired symbolic abilities, that they can think symbolically now, that they're not just totally plugged into the material world. They're thinking in material terms. And even stranger, on the walls of the painted caves and rock shelters all around the world start appearing depictions of supernatural beings. For example, creatures that are part animal and part human in form. There's a technical term for these creatures. They're called therianthropes, from the Greek therion, which means wild beast, and anthropos, which means man. And when you study these images, which, by the way, are virtually identical all around the world, even though these cultures were not in contact with one another, you realize that you're looking at beings who are captured or depicted in the process of transformation. They're shape-shifters. They're changing their form from one form to another. And to cut a long story very, very short indeed, it's been established now that the common factor in all of this art is shamanism and altered states of consciousness. We still have shamans in the world today in tribal and hunter-gatherer societies. And shamanism always involves altered states of consciousness, trance states, if you like. And these states of consciousness are often brought about by the consumption of powerful visionary, we call them hallucinogenic plants. And there's just absolutely compelling evidence, and I detail this in my book, Supernatural,